हेलो एंड वेलकम एवरीवन टू अवर लेटेस्ट जनरल रिव्यू ऑफ हाई प्रोटीन वर्सेस मीडियम प्रोटीन डिलीवरी एंड इक्वल टोटल एनर्जी डिलीवरी इन क्रिटिकली इल पेशेंट्स। दिस इज आरसीटी व्हिच हैज बीन डन इन जापान एंड पब्लिश्ड इन क्लिनिकल न्यूट्रिशन दिस मंथ। इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ प्रोटीन डिलीवरी इन क्रिटिकल केयर रिमेन्स एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कंसर्न। वी आर स्टिल नॉट वेरी श्योर हाउ मच प्रोटीन इज टू बी गिवन ड्यूरिंग क्रिटिकल इलनेस। Muscle volume has been regarded as one of the important outcomes of nutritional therapy. There are very few markers which we can use to know whether we are giving proper nutrition or not, especially the protein. So in these cases, muscle volume and the measurement of this volume during the admission and after admission is something which is used as a measure for good nutrition that has been provided during the critical illness. The objective of this study is to compare a high protein target of 1.8 grams per kg per day with a medium protein target of 0.9 grams per kg per day with equal total energy delivery during the critical care admission. The efficacy of belt type electrical muscle stimulation EMS, which was induced whole lower body contraction on muscle volume maintenance in acute phase of ICU rehabilitation, was also analyzed in this study. Now, patients who got admitted to the ICU from August 2018 through to September 2019 were included in the study. The exclusions being lower limb injury, including infection, amputation of limb ischemia, death before day 10, early expected discharge from the ICU, that is before day 10, designated as do not resuscitate or early death prognosis, CT unable cases, because CT was the method by which they were assessing the muscle volume. In cases where CT was contraindicated, they were not included in the study. Extracorporeal membrane oxygenation, pacemaker implanted because we are giving electrical stimulations, and lastly, inability to get in an informed consent. Now, there were two study periods. The first is between August 2018 through to March 2019. The second is April 2019 through to September 2019. In the former period, the standard rehabilitation protocol was maintained without the electrical muscle stimulation, and it was followed in both the groups. In the later phase, the rehabilitation protocol included this electrical muscle stimulation. In each period, the included cases were assigned a random number of 0 or 1 using software, respectively designated them as high protein or a medium protein group, with no adjustment being done for covariations. Early discharge, alive patients, and death before day 10 were excluded from outcome analysis. Now, intervention. The first target energy amount was 20 kilocalorie per kg per day with a permissive underfeeding. Malnutrition was determined as a low body mass index, that is less than 18.5, or presumed recent blood body loss of more than 10% of body weight, or if it was a physician's decision. In these patients, the target nutrition was received in a much slower manner compared to patients who were having a normal BMI. When a patient was found to be malnourished, the final target was increased to 30 kilocalorie per kg per day. Within 48 hours of ICU admission, enteral feeding was started or via nasogastric tube. Enteral continuous feeding was given at a rate of 10 to 20 ml per hour, and it was increased by 10 to 20 ml per hour to reach the necessary calorie goal every 8 hourly with a gastric residual volume of less than 500 ml. The protein delivery, which was the main difference of intervention in the study, was targeted as 1.8 gram per kg per day in the high protein group and 0.9 gram per kg per day in the medium protein group. Now, one thing we must understand in the limitations of this study is that when you're giving such different levels of protein with same calorie, you are definitely giving some different type of protein. So that becomes a major difference because you are giving two very different type of protein in the two groups. Early rehabilitation was induced by physical therapist from day 2 in both the groups. EMS was conducted for day 2 with the belt type muscle stimulation, and in addition to this, in the former group, that is the first period, they also did muscle load testing. Now coming to the outcomes, the primary outcome was set as femoral muscle volume change from the first day of admission through to day 10. Now in both groups, plain femoral CT was performed on day 1 and day 10 to calculate the muscle volume. The functional status score, that is ICU stay and the quality of life and all that, was evaluated by a physical therapist blinded to the patient group. Now coming to the results, total 382 patients were admitted into the ICU during this period. Out of this, the first period, which was without the EMS protocol, admitted 197 patients, and with the EMS protocol, they admitted 185 patients. Out of this, 132 were excluded in the EMS without the EMS period and 116 in the with EMS period. So ultimately 65 were included in the without EMS protocol and 69 in the with EMS protocol. So coming to the basic characteristics, 60 patients were in the high protein group, 57 in the medium protein group. The age is more or less similar. Sex is predominantly male. The BMI was around 20. So there is not much difference between the two groups. The Apache 2 was 18, which shows a moderately severe population with a SOFA scoring of around 6 to 7. So most of the admissions again is sepsis and heart failure with stroke. And most of the characteristics are same in both the groups. Now, if we look in terms of the energy delivery, it was roughly similar in the two groups. And the delivery of the food via enteral and parenteral was also roughly similar in both the groups. However, as expected, and as was the protocol of the trial, the protein delivery was significantly different in the two groups. And as we can see here, around 1.5 to 2 grams per kg per day was achieved in the high protein group, while in the low protein group, it was around 10. While in the medium protein group, it was around 1 gram per kg per day. Now, if you look at our outcomes, the outcome was significantly better with high protein group, that is the muscle volume loss was more in the medium protein group as seen over here. The muscle volume loss was statistically significant. The rest parameters were not significantly different between the two groups. So considering the limitations that it is a very small study with its associated limitations, this study concluded that for critically ill patients, high protein delivery provided better muscle volume maintenance, but only with active early rehabilitation. Now, the take-home messages for us from this study are that it is definitely a positive trial of what is mostly the current practice all over the world, because the most protein that is being recommended currently is 1.5 to 2 for critically ill patients. So it definitely establishes the current practice and the correct guidelines which are being done. So definitely we will continue with giving higher protein intakes and ensure early physical activity in the patients so that the nutritional recovery and the rehabilitation is much better in patients who are admitted into the ICU. Thank you for your patience, and check our website for further information.